Good morning, students. Welcome back to History Lecture. Today, we are going to start with the chapter number 5, Education. As we all know, education is very important. If we want to make our future bright, then we should take a proper education. If we are not going to take the proper education, we can't make our future bright. If we want to start a business or if we want to do a job, then the education is very important. So in this chapter, we are going to review the main stages and the schemes of development of educational system in India. We are going to see the education system in India. Okay. In this chapter, we are going to cover the primary education, secondary education, national policy on education, then Indira Gandhi National Open University, also about the research institute like science and medical, then also about engineering, then research institution like medicine, then agriculture. So definitely it will help you in your future. Now again, there are some changes Indian government had made in education policy, and the new policy of 2020 has been published. Sir Roy already have given you the video on that topic, so I'm not going to talk on that. I hope you all have seen the Sir Roy's video on the new education policy of 2020. Now we will begin with our lesson. In this chapter, we shall review the main stages and the schemes in the development of educational system in India. So what we are going to study in this chapter? The main stages and the schemes in the development of educational system. How the education system was developed in India, that we are going to study. Or what are the efforts they have made to develop the education system in India. We shall take into consideration primary, secondary as well as higher education and beside research institution in some presentative areas. So what we are going to consider in this lesson? The primary, secondary as well as higher education, and besides that we are going to study about research institutes in some representative areas. This will give us an idea of the educational system throughout the country. And when we are going to refer all those things, then only it will give us idea how is the education system throughout the country. The first census of independent India in 1951 revealed the extreme complexity and instability of educational issues in country. So when the first census was done in the year 1951, it revealed means make known to everyone that the extreme complexity means or complicated, complexity means complicated, and intractability means very difficult to manage of educational issues in country. So when the first census of independent India was done, that time they found that it is very complicated and very difficult to deal with the educational issues in the country. So there were many issues related to the educational system in our country. In the first census, the literacy level was 17%. So the literacy level was only 17%, and it rose as shown below. Now you can see the chart which is given in on the textbook page number 23. So when the census was done in the year 1971, the literacy level rose to 34%. Then 1981, it rose to 43%. 1991, it rose to 52%. And in the 2001, it rose to 64%. So after 10 years, they were doing the census, and when they were doing the census, they saw that literacy level is increasing. Improving this percentage was a serious challenge for the government of India, and it was a serious challenge because when the first census was done, it was only 17%. Then slowly the percentage is increasing. Several remedial schemes were put in place to deal with it and to improve the condition of education. The government put various schemes so the education can be developed in our country. So more people, they will take the education, the more students they will take the education, and the literacy level will be increased. So that is why the government has introduced many remedial schemes. So the literacy level in the country will increase. Next one, we are going to move to the primary education. Primary education refers to the schooling given to children in the 6 to 14 years age group. In 1988, the central government started a scheme for the spread of primary education and to improve educational standards. It is known as Operation Blackboard. So, the education which is given to the children in the age group of 6 to 14, and that is referred to as primary education. In the year 1988, the central government, they started one scheme for the spread of primary education and to improve the education standard, and it is known as Operation Blackboard. Why they started the scheme Operation Blackboard? Because they want to improve the educational standard and also they want to spread the primary education. The government made funds available to help improve the standard of schools and to fulfill minimum educational needs. So even the government, they provide the funds. Why they provide the funds or the money? So the educational needs will be fulfilled, and also it will help to improve the standard of the school, and that is why the government started providing funds to the schools for the improvement of the standard of schools and for the fulfillment of minimum educational needs. Now, which are the minimum educational needs? Such as at least 2 proper classrooms, then toilets facilities, and one of the teacher to be female. So there should be one female teacher. Next one is blackboard, maps, and laboratory apparatus. So the blackboard will be provided in the classroom, even the maps will be there, and the laboratory apparatus for the science to do the experiment. Next one is a small library so students can read the different books, then a playground. So the playground should be there in the school so students can play. Next one is sports equipments. So the sports equipments like balls, bat, different equipments are there. So that should be available, made available in the school. So the government made funds available for the minimal educational needs. And in that need, we have seen like 2 proper classroom, then toilets, one of the female teacher, then blackboard, map, then laboratory apparatus, and a small library, playground, sport equipment, etc. This scheme helped the primary education system to gain some momentum. And because of this scheme, the primary education have got some momentum or importance. Next one, do you know? After the formation of Maharashtra state in 1960, as we all know, the state of Maharashtra was formed on 1st May 1960. The government took the decision to implement a common statewide curriculum for standard 1st to 7th. Principal Syed Ralph of ST College, Mumbai, was assigned the task of preparing the draft of this curriculum. So, after the formation of Maharashtra state, the government took the decision to implement a common statewide curriculum. So, all over the state of Maharashtra, there will be the same curriculum from standard 1st to standard 7th. Okay, and that responsibility was assigned to Principal Syed Ralph of ST College. Next, in 1994, the scheme was expanded and provision was made for one additional classroom and for appointing one more teacher in schools with an enrollment of more than 100 students, with priority given to girls' schools, schools with a majority of scheduled caste, tribe, students and schools in rural areas. So in the 1994, this scheme was expanded and provisions was made more additional. And what they have add in that, they add one more classroom and one more extra teacher. So in whichever school the strength of students is more than 100, then they have add one more classroom or the additional classroom, and they also appoint one more teacher in that particular school. In which school? The enrollment of school is more than 100 students, with priority given to the girls' schools, and more priority were given to the girls' schools. Also the schools with a majority of scheduled caste, where the scheduled caste students are taking the education, or the tribe students. And schools in the rural areas, wherever the rural area is there, if such schools were there, the priority were given to those schools. It was also made binding upon the state government to appoint female teachers to 50% of the post in the schools. So it is made compulsory that 50% seats or the post were kept for the female teachers. So the state government to appoint 50% teachers to the female teachers in the school. Again, in the year 1994, the District Primary Education Program, DPEP, was started with the objective of universalization of primary education. It was implemented in 7 states, including Maharashtra. So in the year 1994, the District Primary Education Program, DPEP, was started with the objective of universalization of primary education, means everyone should get the education. It is universalization. It is open for everyone, every child. It was implemented in 7 states, including Maharashtra. And this universalization of education, primary education, this program was implemented in 7 states, and also it implemented in Maharashtra. The plan envisaged 100% attendance in primary schools, arresting students drop out, education for girls and for the physically handicapped. So these are the programs were introduced in this DPEP program. So the first one is 100% attendance in the primary school. If the child has taken the admission in a primary school, then his 100% attendance is compulsory. Then the second one is arresting the students dropout. Arresting means the students, some students, they are taking the admission, but after a few years, they are dropping out from the school due to some financial issues. They were not able to pay the school fees, or they were not able to purchase the textbooks or the books. And that is why we have to find out those students, and to those students, they have to provide the free education, and also they have to provide the textbooks. Then education for girls. For the girls, the education is very important. Also, for the physically handicapped, there are some students, those are physically handicapped. In Hindi, we call it as a viklang. So those students should also get the chance of study in school. So this was the plan. It include programs such as research on and evolution of primary education, alternative education, creating social awareness, etc. So even it includes the programs like research on evolution of primary education. On primary education, there should be research, and creating social awareness among the students. There should be social awareness should be created about society. Then the alternative education. If any child who is not good in subjects like, so he can take the alternative education like drawing, dance, karate. So he can take those subjects, etc. So the midday meal scheme was started in 1995 to provide proper nourishment for students. Also, the government started the midday meal scheme. So the students will come to the school, they will get the meal to eat. So many parents, those who are poor, they were sending students to the school. At least the students, they will get the food over there. Because if the parent, if they are not able to afford the food for the child, then what the parent was thinking, that if I'm going to send my child to the school, definitely he will get something over there to eat. And because of this school, many students, they got the education. So along with the food, they got the education also. So this was a good scheme, was introduced in the year 1995 to provide the proper nourishment for the students. And because of the scheme, it provide the proper nourishment or the care or the good health for the students if they are going to eat the proper food. So that was the motto behind this scheme. Now this is very important. Can we achieve this? This is a big question mark for us. In 1991, Kerala became a full literate state. What step must be taken to achieve 100% of literacy in Maharashtra as well? So if you are going to see the literacy rate of Kerala, it is high compared to other states of India. So the Kerala is 100% literate. All people in the state of Kerala are literate. They are educated. So what are the steps should other state governments should take to make those state 100% literate? You have to think on this. Next one, do you know? Tarabai Modak began work in the field of education in Bordi and Kosbar. She started Anganwadis for Adivasi children. She worked hard to bring in learning by doing method to start Kuran Shalas, meadow schools, and to spread vocational technical education. So not only the government, but there are other people, those have also working hard in the field of education to provide education to the children. And in that, Tarabai Modak was one. She began work in the field of education in Bordi and Kosbar. So these are the villages in Maharashtra. And she started Anganwadis for Adivasi children. Anganwadis is like a preschool. Okay. So she started the Anganwadis for Adivasi children. She worked hard to bring in the learning by doing method. So she worked hard to bring the learning by doing method. Learning by doing method means, in, for example, in a science, what we are doing, whenever we are doing an experiment, that time we are doing that experiment and then we learn something. So she focus on that method only, learning by doing. So whatever we are learning, we have to implement that in a practically. That was the motto. She also started the Kuran Shalas or the meadow schools, and to spread the vocational technical education. If youth are taking the education, for them, they were giving the vocational technical education so they can get the job anywhere. Then the second person is Anutai Vak, established institution at Kosbad for the progress of Adivasis, Thane district. It is known as the Kosbad project. She started cranches, nurseries, primary schools, adult education classes, Bal Vikas training school, etc. for the education of Adivasis. And another person, Anutai Vak, she also established the institution at Kosbad, and that is known as the Kosbad project. And why she established the Kosbad project, or why the, what is the motto behind or the objective behind the Kosbad project? Progress of Adivasis in Thane district. And because of that, she started the cranches. Now what is cranches? Cranches is a place where young children are cared for during the day while their parents go to work. When the parents go to work, that time those young children were bring over here and they were taking care of those children during a day. And that is called as a cranches. Or we can say a babysitting, like we have a babysitting nowadays. So it is like a only. So the young children were brought over here and they were also educated. When they are taking care of the young children, that time they are also educating them. And that is called as a cranches. Also, she started the nurseries and primary schools. Even she started the adult education classes. Now, what is adult education classes? Means those who are 18 plus. So there are many students or the adult people, those are taking the education after 18 years. So for them also she started the classes. Bal Sevika training schools. There are some people, those are taking care of the students or the children in nursery schools or in pre-primary schools. So for them also the training program was started. And all those things she has started for the education of Adivasis. Now we are going to study about secondary education. Now what comes in secondary education? Secondary education start from 5th standards to the 12th standards. Okay. And now today we are going to learn what are the steps had been taken to develop the secondary education in India. That we are going to see. So after the independence, the education minister, Maulana Abdul Kalam Azad, he decided to bring some fundamental change in the field of education. And according to that, he started the University Education Commission, was set up for this purpose. To make fundamental changes in the field of education, he started the University Education Commission for this purpose. And what is the work of this commission? This commission recommended the appointment of a separate commission for secondary education. As we all know, the university education, it is higher education, means after 12th standard. So what they said, that if you want to develop the primary and the secondary education, then we have to separate both the commission as primary and the secondary. And the separate commission for secondary was started. And accordingly, in 1952 and 53, the Mudaliar Commission was appointed, and for that purpose they appointed the one more commission, and the name of that commission is Mudaliar Commission. At that time, the pattern of education consists of 11 plus 4 years for first degree or of 11 plus 1 plus 3 years. Means right now we are having a 10th standard, we are having a board exam. But before that, the 11th was the board exam. When we are going to reach to the 11th standard, that time you have to give the board exam. And after that 4 years, the degree course will be there. If you are going to see the education system, we know that at 10th, we give the board exam. Then another board exam we have to give on when we are going to reach to the 12th standard. And another board exam we have to give when we are going to reach to the 15th, okay, graduation. But before that, it was like that. Like at 11th standard, they have to give the board exam. Then 4 years, they have to do the degree course. Now, at 12th standard, we have to do the graduation. And after that, 3 years, graduation course. And then on 15th, we get the graduate. So this Mudaliar Commission has given the two patterns. That is either 11 plus 4 or first degree or of 11 plus 1 plus 3 years. Means 11, there will be a board exam, then again 1, there will be a, and 12, there will be again a board exam, and 3 years degree course will be there. After 3 years you will get the graduation. If you have your grandparents, then you can ask them. They will tell you when they used to reach to the 11th standard, that time they have to give the board exam. So that's all. The next we will continue in the next lecture.